What's going on, guys? Wild card playoff time here. St. Louis Rams coming to town to play us again. They beat us good in our matchup in the regular season just a few weeks ago. But first things first, Adrian Peterson is out for the next two games, and we have to sign another running back that's going to be backing up Toby Gerhart. And I have some options. I was thinking about doing Steve Slayton because he's fast, good acceleration, but when I saw his carrying rating at 56, I had to pass on that one. I also thought about Chester Taylor, bring him back to Minnesota for the playoffs, or Lawrence Maroney, or Marion Barber, but I had to choose the right guy for the job, and that is Pierre Thomas. Can't believe he isn't on a team, but I'll take him a one-year contract for the playoffs. So here we are at the Metrodome. Last time we played the Rams, they beat us 36-14, so we're looking for vengeance, but this time we're in our dome as opposed to theirs. So it is time for the first playoff game in my Minnesota Vikings franchise series. And so let's get into the action. Our first possession. First play of the game is a handoff to Toby Gerhart. Good blocking set up by Nate Potter. And that's going to be a rush of 14 yards. Gerhart getting it going early. And now first and 10 for Potter. He's going to pass this time and he finds Devin Aromashadu. Quickly, the Vikings getting into St. Louis territory. A 10-yard catch by Devin. And now second and 8. Play action. And he is sacked off the edge by Chris Long. Ponder backed up to the 50-yard line now on 3rd and 13. Here comes Chris Long again. Ponder sacked on back-to-back plays. And now it's St. Louis's turn on offense. 3rd and 8. The give is to Steven Jackson. Great blocking by some wide receivers on the right side. He's going to get a first down up to the 35-yard line. 1st and 10. Next play. Bradford play action to Jackson. And now he's going to throw it as far as he can. Denario Alexander beating Sean Jones on the play to the 4-yard line. 60-yard completion. 3rd and goal from the 6. Bradford all the time in the world. He looks to the end zone. Finds his man out of bounds though. And they would have to settle for a field goal. And now we're trying to get our offense back going again. There's a 3rd and 2 pass to Jim Kleinsaucer to move the chains. And on 3rd and 12, Ponder looks to Vasante Shenko, a guy he always targets on 3rd down. Edging towards St. Louis territory, once again, Ponder to Shenko, a 1st down, get him to the 42-yard line. Back into St. Louis territory, but the Rams defense would force a 3rd down. And Ponder to pass, looking and throwing across his body. Nearly intercepted, looking for Plaxico Burress. Another drive comes to an end. We'll go into the Vikings' next possession, start of the 2nd quarter. Ponder play action rolls out and looking for Jenkins. And he overthrows him by a ton right into the arms of ex-Vikings linebacker Ben Lieber. Giving St. Louis excellent field position at the Vikings 34. From here, Bradford out of the gun. Hit as he throws, but he finds Brandon Gibson. That's going to get him to the 15-yard line. It's a 19-yard completion. New set of downs. 2nd and 3, give is to Steven Jackson off the right side. Shakes off a defender and gets into the end zone for the first touchdown of the game. St. Louis up 10-0 in the first half. Minnesota trying to get a good drive going, and they're just going to run the ball. Toby Gerhart up the middle. Great blocking, getting him 22 yards all the way to the 42-yard line. And they'll give it back to Gerhart on 3rd and 1 as they're in St. Louis territory for the 3rd time already in this game with no points to show for it. And on 3rd and 9, look at the pressure coming off of both edges. Ponder is put down, and Minnesota has to punt again. St. Louis's ball now, 6 minutes left in the 2nd quarter, and looking for Sims Walker, but he cannot hang on. The Rams now have to punt on 4th down, and the punt is going to be going to Kenyon Barner at about the 31-yard line. He's going to feel that has some blockers up in front. Spin move left, cut right, getting to the 47-yard line, almost back in St. Louis territory. Can they do something with this drive? Ponder out of the backfield for Jim Kleinsaucer. A couple of defenders meet him, but he's able to muscle his way for a 1st down. They get it to 3rd and 2, and they give to Gerhart and some power running up the middle. That'll be enough for a 1st down. And now 3rd and 9. Ponder trying to move the chains, and he's just going to throw it to Booker out of the backfield. Other receivers were not open, so we're just going to make it a shorter field goal attempt. And Longwell's kick is up and good. So it's 3-10 now, 3 minutes left in the 2nd quarter. We'll go to the Rams' next possession. 3rd and 6, Bradford looking deep left side, but the pass falls incomplete. And the Rams have to punt once again to Kenyon Barner, who's going to take this from the Minnesota 23-yard line, looking for some blocks ahead of him, shoves away a defender, has some speed, kicks it into high gear, going up the left sideline into Rams territory, 42-yard line, great return by Kenyon, and the handoff goes to Gerhardt out of the shotgun, trying to catch the Rams off guard, but they are not fooled, setting up a 3rd and 13 for Ponder out of the gun. Heaving it long right side, Plaxico Burress goes up and gets it. Minnesota now in field goal range, trying to see what they can do on 2nd and 7, give it to Gerhardt, but met by a bunch of St. Louis defenders, loses 1 yard, and they'll go to 3rd down now. And Ponder squeezes this one inside of 3 defenders. The perfect pass to Kyle Rudolph. First down now, trying to run some hurry up. Ponder, first and goal from the 4-yard line. Trying to get some more points on the board. And he's going to look left. Plaxico Burress, and it's picked off by Quinton Michael in the end zone. That was just a bad throw on my part. I was trying to hit Burress on the sideline, but Michael made a great play. So the Rams go into the second half with a 7-point lead and get into Minnesota territory with Bradford hooking up with Mike Sims Walker. And then on 1st down and 10, good protection for Bradford looking deep. And that's Lance Kendricks beating Donald Butler. With no safety help, Butler gets beat, and Rams are back inside the 10-yard line. And 1st and goal, Bradford to pass. Plenty of time, waits for Brandon Gibson to get open, and he finds him, and he dives into the end zone for a Rams touchdown. And they're up 17-3 in the third. And then Gerhardt on 1st and 10 from the 27-yard line. He'll go up, get 16 yards, doing a good job of running so far. And now at midfield on 3rd and 2, the pass is to Pierre Thomas out of the backfield. That'll be good enough for a 1st down. Chains keep moving. But then on 3rd and 3, Gerhardt tries to get the 1st down, only gets 2.5 yards. And on 4th and inches, I just decide to play it safe. We're going to kick a 51-yard field goal with Ryan Longwell. Kick is up from the veteran kicker, and it is just good. So we are now down by 11 points, only have 6 points on the board, and now we're in the 4th quarter. And it begins with Ponder hooking up with Devin Aromashadu for a 1st down. And on 2nd and 4, the give is to Toby Gerhardt, getting a lot of carries in this game. He'll go right up the middle for another 1st down. Chains keep moving. Ponder under pressure. Chris Long, his 3rd sack on the day. No chance right there. 3rd and 7 now from the 38. Ponder finds Kyle Rudolph over the middle. Shakes off a defender. He's going to get him to the 21-yard line now. And the Vikings looking to add some more points on 1st down. Give is to Gerhardt. Blocking on the right side. Shanko out in front. And that's going to be good for 9 yards. He cut it out right side. And after the chains move, they're going to give it back to Gerhardt. Breaks the tackle and goes up the middle. 7-yard gain. We'll go forward to 3rd and 3 now, looking for a touchdown. Ponder over the middle, and he hits Shanko on the side, looking for Kyle Rudolph. Those two are meeting across the middle. And so we're just going to kick a field goal, make it an 8-point game now, 17-9. 3 field goals from Lyon Longwell is all we have so far. 7 minutes left. The Rams trying to take away some of this clock and win this game, and Bradford finds Denario Alexander, and he's going to get him another 1st down. On 2nd and 9, the handoff is to Steven Jackson, but Kevin Williams blows it up in the backfield. Shotgun handoff goes nowhere. So Bradford out of the shotgun, Jackson to his right, under pressure, Kevin Williams puts him down. 4th and 21 coming up, his 2nd sack on the day. Kevin Williams making some plays, and now the punt has to go to Kenyon Barner, who will take it at his 39-yard line. He's going to step up, spin right, make some defenders look silly, and he's going to be tackled out at the St. Louis 42-yard line. Kenyon giving us great field position in this game, and we're going to give it to Gerhardt, a guy who's been giving a ton of carries this game. He's going to take it all the way up to the 23-yard line for a 19-yard gain. And on 1st and 10, handoff, Gerhardt right side, and look at this blocking. Gerhardt turning the corner all the way to the end zone, dives in, touchdown Minnesota, a 2-point conversion from tying this game up. Gerhardt and Ponder excited, but we gotta go get the 2-point conversion. So Burress coming in motion, Ponder back to pass, looks like nobody's open. Ponder from the 10-yard line scrambles up, and he gets into the end zone. Minnesota ties the game 17 apiece. And the Rams now with the ball. A few minutes left in this game, trying to break the tie. 3rd and 10, Bradford over the middle to Lance Kendricks, moving the chains. Rams gave up a 14-point lead, but are now trying to put the Vikings away. 2nd and 7, pitch out right to Steven Jackson. Butler, bad angle on him, and Jackson is inside the Minnesota 35, into long-distance field goal range, and they're going to keep pounding the ball. Jackson left side. It's another 1st down. Minnesota having trouble stopping the run, but they get the Rams on a 3rd down and 9, and they're going to run the ball with Jackson again. He nearly gets the 1st down. Jared Allen tackles him after 8 yards, and Josh Brown is going to come on a kick, a short field goal to give the Rams the lead, and it is up and good. 20-17 Rams. just over a minute for the Vikings to come back and score a field goal, and Schenko right side makes the catch. Move the chains, but Minnesota's got to get it going quick. 30 seconds left in the game, 2nd and 10 from the 37. Ponder throwing as far as he can, and Emmanuel Arsenault comes down with it. His first catch of the game. Right time, right place, 5 seconds left. Minnesota going for the win with one timeout left. Ponder looking end zone, knocked away, looking for Kyle Rudolph. 2 seconds left, and so Ryan Longwell comes on to attempt a short field goal, and we have overtime, 20 apiece. Great game so far from Minnesota and St. Louis. They'll meet in the middle for the coin toss. Playoff rules come into effect for overtime games. We've had some thrilling overtime games already this season, and we win the toss. We're going to take the ball from the 10-yard line. Ponder, Toby Gerhart, the workhorse in this game, right up the middle. That's how we ran them all day. And then 3rd and 1, looking for a very important conversion. And Gerhart goes up, gets that 1 yard. The chains move. And now we go 1st and 10. Ponder looking for Plaxico Burress on the left side. Gets up past the 30, past the 40, out of the 42-yard line. So we're close to midfield now. Handoff left to Pierre Thomas on the counter. And he's going to get up to the 50-yard line at midfield now. 2nd and 2, give us to Pierre Thomas. Will go up the middle left side, plenty of room to run. Thomas beats the safety, no one's gonna catch him. Pierre Thomas just took us to the divisional playoffs. 50-yard touchdown in overtime, Minnesota victorious. Ponder and Hutchinson give Leslie Frazier the Gatorade bath. Toby Gerhart is your player of the game. 30 carries for 183 yards, the workhorse in this game. Tremendous running, and Pierre Thomas on the 50-yard touchdown has taken us to the next round of the playoffs. We win our first playoff game in the Vikings franchise series in a thrilling overtime win. And here are the stats. Ponder with 260 yards passing. We were able to overcome the 2 interceptions and get the victory running the ball. Toby Gerhart, what a fantastic job on the ground today. Steven Jackson, almost 100 yards. We did better in the second half than we did in the first. Pierre Thomas, of course, the game-winning touchdown. Burress had 57 yards receiving. Schenko, 33. Rudolph, 40. And importantly, Emmanuel Arsenault had the 54-yard catch to get us into field goal range and help send this game to overtime. James Laurinaitis with 20 total tackles, because most of this game I spent running the ball right up the middle with Toby Gerhart, right into the heart of their defense, and it worked out well for us. Chris Long, big day with 3 sacks. Kevin Williams also had 2. Lieber and Michael had the interceptions. It was a very thrilling game, and we are moving on now to the divisional round of the playoffs. You can see here the scoring summary, and we'll recap the rest of the games that happened on Wild Card Weekend, starting off with Philadelphia beating the New York Giants 35-32 at home. LeSean McCoy had 2 touchdowns, as did rookie wide receiver Alshon Jeffrey for the Giants, but they won in overtime as well on an Alex Henry field goal kick. And Mike Kafka was actually playing quarterback with them, and they had to overcome 5 interceptions. We'll check out some more of the player stats here. McCoy and Vereen, both over 100 yards on the ground. Alshon Jeffrey with 79 yards receiving. DeSean Jackson with 123. So Philadelphia still alive on the NFC side of the playoffs, a team we might end up playing later. Terrell Thomas, 3 interceptions, wow. And Kansas City Chiefs over the New York Jets, 35-23. Jamal Charles had 3 touchdowns in this one, and Ocho Cinco, the New York Jet, also scored. The Chiefs had one of the better records throughout most of this NFL season and won the AFC West. Greg McElroy playing quarterback for the Jets. I'm not sure what's up with Sanchez. Jamal Charles with 30 carries on the day. They ran him like we ran Gerhart and advanced to the divisional round. Tony Moyaki, a big day receiving 7 carries for 151 yards. I'm not quite sure if Rex Ryan guaranteed a Super Bowl victory in this season, but they're knocked out of the playoffs once again. Now we'll check out the Houston Texans beating the New England Patriots 27-25. I can't remember if they made the playoffs in year one of my franchise, but they have some great receivers. But as you can see here, the Patriots had a touchdown with 2 minutes remaining and missed the 2-point conversion that would have tied the game. So Brady is defeated by Matt Schaub and the Houston Texans. Danny Woodhead, 21 carries. Nobody really ran the ball all that well. But Patrick Edwards had a pair of touchdowns. Andre Johnson played well. And Houston Texans are advancing in the playoffs. And if they didn't make the playoffs last year, then this would have to be the first playoff victory for the Texans in franchise history. Here is the schedule coming up for this coming week, the divisional round of the playoffs. The Texans at the Steelers, the Vikings at the Cardinals, the Chiefs at the Colts, and the Eagles at the Saints. So next episode, we travel to Arizona to take on the Arizona Cardinals in the divisional round of the playoffs.